This module introduced the mechanics of magnetism in free space. We began with an introduction to magnetic fields. We talked about the two possible sources of magnetic fields, changing electric fields and moving electric charge. The moving electric charge can exist on an atomic scale, such as when electrons follow orbital patterns around an atomic nucleus, or they can exist on a more macroscopic scale, such as when current flows along a conductive path. We introduced magnetic flux density, B, and magnetic field, H. We discussed the solenoidal law, which says that because of the lack of magnetic monopoles, all magnetic flux lines flow in circles. We talked about Amperes law, which is especially useful when analyzing symmetric geometries, and Biot-Savart's law, which can be used for any arbitrary current source distribution. We also talked about the magnetic vector potential, which is a mathematical tool defined by setting the curl of the vector potential equal to the magnetic flux density. This is useful in that it simplifies the integrand used in the Biot-Savart law, making many problems easier to solve than if we just applied Biot-Savart directly. We also discussed the magnetic force on a moving charge, which is equal to the charge multiplied by the cross product of the charge's velocity and the magnetic flux density. And we introduced the Lorentz force law, which combines the electrostatic and magnetostatic forces that act on a charge when both electric and magnetic fields are present. Again, this is a lot of material. Please take the time to work through the example and practice problems to make sure you understand everything we've covered so far before moving on to the next module.